damages!
I waited until they were out of sight, and then I ran. I moved as quietly as I could, down and down and down. Finally, I reached the bottom deck. I ran to the hallway and looked around frantically.
There it is!
It was just where I thought it would be, sitting under the opening of the vent. I ran over and snatched it from the floor. As I ran back toward the stairs and freedom.
Hey, little girl. Why don't you come with me, little girl, on a magic carpet ride?
The door to the incinerator opened, and a man stepped out. It was Hongo. Kentaro Hongo. 9 years later, we would call him Ace.
Ah, how wonderful to see you decided to come back.
His smile made my blood run cold. A little mechanical, as if someone had simply pulled up the corners of his mouth.
Come with me. We must continue the experiment.
I shook my head, eyes wide. Slowly I began to walk backwards. One step. Two steps. Three steps. Then I spun around and broke into a run. I felt Hongo's hand close over my left wrist.
I said come with me.
There was an edge of insanity to his voice now. I pulled as hard as I could.
No, I don't want to. Let me go. Please let go of me.
I shook my body and flailed my arms, trying desperately to get Hongo to let go of me. But I was still only a child. I was no match for a man like Hongo.
Stop struggling, goddammit. Do as I tell you.
He heaved on my arm, trying to pull me into the incinerator. I screamed,
help me! Somebody help me!
Then, suddenly,
Akane!
The door to the stairs flew open, and my brother Aoi burst out of it. Behind him came Seven and Snake.
Akane!
No.
Akane!
He cried my name again as he leapt towards Hongo.
You came back!
You're too late, idiot.
Hongo threw his full weight against my arm, pulling us both into the incinerator. The force of it threw me to the floor. I scrambled to my feet and looked toward the open number 9 door. Hongo stood between it and me, but behind him, I could see my brother, his fist clenched. But those fists never reached Hongo. Wow, what a jerk. That's cheating, man. With a cold, heartless screech of metal on metal, the door slammed shut. Hongo glanced at me mechanically, his face registering that there was an object there, but not anything he would consider a human being. Then he turned away and walked to the red that sat next to the door. He reached into his pocket and removed two bracelets. He waved them both over the scanner panel. Two asterisks appeared on the red. He checked the screen, then tossed the bracelets carelessly onto the floor. What was he doing? What was the point? He made no effort to explain himself, of course. He said nothing at all, and walked past me as though I were nothing more than a rock by the roadside.
A few moments later...
Oh, is this going to be a puzzle room? The double doors slid shut as well. Faintly, I could hear someone pounding on the door behind me. I turned around and ran toward the door with the number 9.
Akane! Akane! Are you okay?
I could hear a voice on the other side of the door. A worried, frightened voice.
Help me!
My throat was already raw, but I screamed as loud as I could. My voice echoed, lonely, around the empty room.
What should I do? I think I'm trapped in here.
Where's Hongo?
He went out the other door.
What? Then it started again.
Warning! Warning! Emergency incineration command has been acknowledged. Automatic incineration will take place in 18 minutes. Please evacuate the incinerator immediately.
Holy shit! Man, I knew what it was going to say, but that is one hell of a creepy voice.
I knew it.
It's starting.
Send a start of the incinerator.
Fuck. Man, I never thought I'd hear that damn voice again after 9 years.
What the hell? What the hell? What are you talking about? It's 9 years this and 9 years that. And when it's not 9 years something, then you're talking about some sort of fucking experiments. What in God's name are you talking about? You're not making any sense.
I'm sorry, Lotus, but we really don't have time to explain it right now. I promise I'll tell you everything once we get out of here.
But...
automatic incineration will take place in 17 minutes.
You know what that means, right? Incinerate means burn. What kind of an idiot do you think I am? I know what incinerate means. Well, God damn it! Okay, okay, fine. I won't ask anything else. Talk about whatever you want. But you have to do something for me. Seven, figure this out.
What? What me?
Just shut up and stop this thing.
How about...
there has to be some sort of emergency shut-off button.
There isn't anything like that.
How the hell do you know?
Because I looked for it 9 years ago.
Yeah, Lotus isn't happy about that. Can't really blame her. Wait. The floor, it's moving. Oh, it's some sort of steampunk thing. What else can I say about it, but...
but what the hell is that?
What else could I say, but...
what is that?
The floor opened, and a machine rose up out of it. It looked like... a computer? At least it kinda did. There was a monitor, a keyboard, and a cross-shaped device of some kind. Something about the machine scared me, but I forced myself to walk up to it. I was terrified. Tears poured down my face. I wiped them off. Even as Mort took their place and forced myself forward. Finally, I reached it. I looked at the screen. It was blank. All I saw was my own frightened face, staring back at me from the glass, drenched in tears. Oh, are we now linked? Am I linked to... is Junpei linked to Akane 9 years ago, in the morphogenetic field sort of way? All I can see on the screen is a reflection of my own face. I'm looking kind of freaked out. And I'm sweating like crazy, but seeing it kind of drives it home. Okay, Junpei, calm down, alright? Everything's gonna be okay. Ugh. Man, I wish that thing would just shut up.
Automatic incineration will take place in 15 minutes!
Alright, back to this thing. If it's only showing up now, then it's gotta be important. But
what the hell am I supposed to do with it?
Hey, move!
Well, she is a hacker, isn't she?
Yeah! Hey, we're all tense, lady. That doesn't mean you gotta shove people around.
Okay, it's turned on. There's nothing on the screen, though. This is bad. This is really bad. There's nothing on here. How are you supposed to do anything with it?
Sure, just press buttons. I'm sure that'll... oh. Huh. At least it's on now. Oh, we're not playing Sudoku.
What's on the screen, though?
What is this?
What the hell? Like, isn't it like... the rules of Sudoku are... you're only allowed numbers 1 to 9 in a box. So, like... you're not allowed in duplicate numbers. Rows, and rows as well. So, basically, you can't have... this 9's got to go here. It can't go anywhere else on this row. Anywhere else in this row. Anywhere in this box. And that's how you just sort of figure it out. Anyway, let's continue on.
Looks like some sort of puzzle.
It's got a bunch of numbers scattered across a 9x9 grid. The numbers range from 1 to 9.
Do you think that if we solve this puzzle, the incinerator will stop? Yeah, well, we can't hope, right?
Alright, puzzle, how do you work?
Man, my goddamn voice again. Automatic incineration will take place in 30 minutes. Get on with it, losers.
Shit. 30 minutes. Can we really do this? My heart feels like it's gonna pop. My heart was pounding like it was about to explode. I stared at the puzzle on the screen. I was sure I had to solve it somehow, but I had no idea how. My connection to Junpei had been gone for a while. His mind was gone. I couldn't get any more information from him. I felt the seconds tick by as I stared at the screen, completely lost. My cheeks felt hot as tears poured over them. Then I heard a voice.
Hey, what are you doing?
It was muffled. I turned around. Pressed against the window of an intruder was a face. A frightening evil face. What?
Hey, what are you doing in there? Get on with it, man. Solve a puzzle. I believe in you, kid.
It was Hongo. How long had he been watching me?
Don't know what to do.
He was yelling, but his voice was still muffled.
It's simple, really. But I suppose I might as well tell you. Just solve a puzzle on that machine.
His laughter was muffled by the door, but it still tore at my heart like the claws of a vicious monster. I bit my lip and glared at Hongo, struggling to hold back hot tears.
You're a terrible person. I hate you.
Oh my, how could you call a gentleman such as myself a terrible person? It's not very nice. Quite fair. Don't use tricks or play dirty. You see, I've even left you a way out.
A way out?
Didn't you hear me? All you have to do is solve that puzzle. Do that and you can stop the incinerator.
What's the point of stopping it? You'll only capture me and make me do this all again. I'm not gonna listen to you. Everyone's gonna throw me back in here. I might as well just die now.
My goodness. Will you listen to anything I've said? Told you I'm a fair man. If you solve a puzzle, the verification function of a red will in turn activate. If the experiment is to deliver valid results, there must be a chance of success. If you succeed, you will escape.
The verification function of a red, what's the big word? I'm like 9 years old.
Then I remembered. Before Hongo left the room, he had scanned 2 bracelets into the red.
So you do remember. Right now, there are 2 numbers in the red. The first is 1 and the second is 3. Say, Akane, what's your number?
I looked down at my left hand. The face of the bracelet showed a 5. Ah, and you paste 5 too. 1 plus 3 plus 5 equals 9. I ran to the door with a 9 on it. I grabbed the red and put my hand against the scanner panel. What?
You really aren't one for listening, are you?
I hear Hunger's muffled voice from across the room.
Already told you, didn't I? Once you solve a puzzle, the verification function of a red will activate. In other words, if you haven't solved a puzzle, you can't enter your number. What kind of a fool are you?
I'm 90 years old, you idiot! I'm scared! Why are you doing this?
You could never understand. Don't know what it's like to spend every day surrounded by monkeys. Now start the experiment. Solve a puzzle.
I can't. I don't know how.
Of course you don't. Isn't that the point? You understand, don't you? Access the morphogenic field and find the solution.
I can't.
Then you'll die. You'll burn alive. Gonna be quite hot in there in a few minutes. Imagine it will be very painful.
What's this laugh? His horrible laugh echoed across the room. And even though his face disappeared from a window, I could hear it. Automatic incineration will take place in 10 minutes. Alrighty. I was crying. Great gulping sobs broken by hiccups that shook my body. I was terrified. I could feel my fear pressing down on me like a tremendous weight. Somehow, I forced my shaking legs to carry me back to the device. I stared at the empty monitor.
I can't. I just can't. There's no way. I can't figure this out.
What was I going to do? I didn't know. I didn't know. I didn't even know where to start. Fear scattered my thoughts, and all I could think of was how I was going to die. My palms were sweating, and my blood was boiling in my veins. It was hot. So hot. I couldn't breathe. I felt dizzy. My heart roared in my chest, as if it would pound itself to pieces. Oh god. So if we solve it, we'll be able to help her solve it. I reached into my pocket. I wrapped my hand around the thing I'd come back to get. The door Jumpy had given me. At least I had that. I held it tight with both hands and prayed.
Help me, Jumpy! Help me! Help me! Jumpy! Jumpy!
Jumpy!
Please, help me! jumpy.
What? Akane.
Akane?
Who the hell is Akane?
Shut up. Just shut the hell up. Seven and Lotus don't understand. I think Clover and Snake have an idea, though. Clover's looking at me. And I think Snake may have figured it out. No, it doesn't matter. They're in my way. Where'd she go? Maybe over here? Akane! Akane, can you hear me, Akane? Say something. Fuck. Did something break our connection? I swear I just heard her. Shit. Akane! Answer me! Akane!
Jumpy?
I spun around. I heard a voice. His voice. I looked around. He wasn't in the room, of course, but I'd heard it so clearly. Like he was right there.
Jumpy!
I screamed as loud as I could. Immediately I heard him call back. Akane!
Jumpy!
That's her. She's there! And that means... Akane, are you in an incinerator right now?
Yes, I am. How did you know?
Now I understand what Santa meant. Right, there's only one way to help her. You were brought here to help my...
You brought here to help my sister, save Akane.
I think I get it now.
Automatic incineration will take place in 7 minutes.
Jumpy, we don't have time.
As quickly as I could, I told him that I had to solve a puzzle in order to stop the incinerator.
Got it.
And I do. I get everything now.
Ah.
At last, I finally understand what all of this means. I know why the Nonia game was held today. I know why we were kidnapped and brought here. It was all for this moment. All of this was planned out to lead to this one moment. Oh my god. This is insane. I can't believe it. There's only one possible answer. June is... Zero is... Akane Kurashiki. She recreated the history of the future that she had a glimpse of 9 years ago. She tried to save herself that way 9 years ago. No. She's trying to save herself right now. That means that there's only one thing for me to do. Even if this is all some sort of insane plan, I will save her. I will save Akane Kurashiki.
My, are we stuck in some kind of paradox?
I must save her, no matter what.
Automatic incineration will take place in 6 minutes.
Jumpy.
Yeah, I know. Just hang on, alright? Promise I'll get you out of there. I'm not gonna let you die. I promise. So don't worry, alright? Just give me a few minutes, okay?
Okay.
My voice shook as I answered. It was hot in the room. Felt like my heart was on fire. 6 minutes or not, my heart burned with my feelings for him. Well, she's only young that time, though. Does she have those feelings all along? Alright, time to get to work, Junpei. Is Snake talking to him about something? Whatever, it doesn't matter. Get out of my way, bitch.
Hey, what are you?
Just trust me, okay? Sorry, Lotus, I didn't mean to snap, but there's a lot more at stake here than your pride. I'll apologize later, alright? Now let's have a look at this thing. We've got numbers all over this grid. Now if I'm looking at this right, I'm going to need to fill in all the empty squares with other numbers from 1 to 9. But I can't use the same two numbers in any horizontal or vertical row. The same has to go for the 3x3 square, with the thick lines around them. Yeah, this sounds a lot like Sudoku. That means I need to put different numbers in the horizontal and vertical rows, as well as the 3x3 spaces. I think that's the rule here.
Alright, bring it on.
I'm gonna do this on my own, with my own mind. I'm gonna solve this problem.
Let's do this shit! Seek a way out in two different timelines.
Alrighty. Oh, come on, game. That's a bit excessive. I've not got... I'm not on the DS. I can't flip my monitor upside down. Okay, we'll just do it this way then. Okay.